हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल स्टार्टेड द न्यू टॉपिक प्रैक्टिकल सेशन न्यू टॉपिक। फर्स्ट टॉपिक इज एंटीनेटल हिस्ट्री टेकिंग। फर्स्ट इंट्रोडक्शन, सिस्टमेटिक सुपरविजन और एग्जामिनेशन और एंड एडवाइस ऑफ ए वुमेन ड्यूरिंग प्रेगनेंसी इज कॉल्ड एंटीनेटल या प्रीनेटल केयर। The supervision should be of a regular and periodical nature in accordance with the principle laid down or more frequently according to the need of the individual. The care should started from the beginning of pregnancy and at delivery. Careful history taking and examination, general and obstetrical, is a part of antenatal care. Aims and objectives of antenatal care: to screen a high risk cases, to treat the complication detected early by examination, to educate mother by demonstrating the labor, to ensure continued medical surveillance and prophylaxis, to remove the fear about delivery and the gain confidence before labor, to ensure normal pregnancy with the delivery of healthy baby, to motivate the couple about the to need of family planning, to give appropriate advice to couple seeking MTP. First, history taking. An obstetrical case should include vital statistics, complaint, history of present illness, history of current and present pregnancy, obstetrical history and past gynecological history, and past medical and surgical history, drug history and allergies, social history, personal history and family history. First, vital statistics. The first, name, then date of first examination and address and age. A woman having the first pregnancy at age of 30 or above is called elderly primi gravida. Extremes of age: teenager or elderly are obstetrical risk factor. Gravida or parity. Gravida is denotes a pregnancy state both present and past irrespectively of a period of gestation. And parity is denotes a state of previous pregnancy beyond the period of viability. Gravida and para refers to pregnancy and not to babies. As such, a woman who delivers twine in first pregnancy is still a gravida 1 and para 1. A pregnant woman with a history of 2 abortion and 1 term delivery can be referred a fourth gravida but first primi para. It is customary in clinical practice to summarize the past obstetrical history by 2 digits affixing the letter P. Does not denote parity here. Example: P is 2+1. 2 denotes 2 viable births and 1 is 1 abortion. Duration of marriage. This is relevant when dealing with pregnancy. Helping is noting fertility or fecundity of a woman. Pregnancy elderly after marriage, high fecundity, and pregnancy later after marriage, low fecundity. Religion, occupation helps in dealing occupation hazards, and occupation of husband give fair idea about the socio-economic status of patient. By this we can know likely complication with her status like anemia, prematurity and preeclampsia. Period of gestation. Duration of pregnancy is to express in term of completed weeks. A fraction of week of more than 3 days is to be considered as completed week. In calculation, the week of gestation in early part of pregnancy, counting is to be done from the first day of last normal menstrual period and last month of pregnancy, counting to be done from expected date of delivery. Most reliable clinical parameter of gestation age assessment is an accurate last menstrual period. In case of person who had used oral contraceptive, LMP may be inaccurate. In case of oral contraceptive use, ovulation may not have accurated 2 weeks after the LMP. In such situation, the estimation of gestation age is more accurate with ultrasonography in first trimester. Complaints. Categorically, the genesis of complaints is to be noted. Even if there is no complaint, inquiry is to be made about the sleep, appetite, bowel habit, and urination. History of present illness. Elaboration of a chief complaints are regarded their onset, duration, severity, use of medication, and progress is to be made. History of current pregnancy. Current pregnancy shall to be noted following way: first trimester, second trimester, and third trimester. History of first trimester. First 12 week is first trimester. Amenorrhea during the reproductive period in an otherwise healthy individual having previous normal period is likely due to pregnancy unless proved otherwise. If history of amenorrhea 6 to 8 week, bleeding per vaginal dark continue is associated with lower abdominal pain, acute and colicky on side initially or lateral whole abdomen, chance of ectopic pregnancy. This is sign of ectopic pregnancy. Placental sign. Cyclic bleeding till 12 week of pregnancy. This happen until residual space in ovary treated by the fusion of D. vera and D. capsularis. Tiredness, malaise. Okay. Placental sign is this happen until residual space, so fusion of residual vera and decidua capsularis. Other normal physiological symptoms: nausea, vomiting, if severe hyperemesis gravidarum, heartburn, constipation, insomnia, increased frequency in urination noted between 8th to 11th week of gestation, cannot be seen with 12 week due to straightening of uterus, against seen in third trimester when uterus pressure increased due to engagement of fetal head. Then history of second and third trimester. No, first one is history of fetal movement. Quickening 8th week, 2 week early in primary gravida, more in third trimester. And symptoms of anemia: miscarriage, hyperemesis gravidarum. If history of amenorrhea, bleeding PV, slight bright red color and painless, dull lower back pain, and if bleeding first and pain later, suggestive of abortion. If history of amenorrhea, bleeding PV, recurrent, sudden, painless, then sign of placenta previa. If symptom of heavy bleeding, partial expulsion of product, conception while resemble grapes with nausea and vomiting, cramping, lower abdominal pain, history of ovarian cyst, sign of molar pregnancy. Ask for vaccination, history of tetanus and RH immunization. Result of all antenatal blood tests, routine and specific. Note, remember the pain may be unrelated to pregnancy, so keep the open mind. Causes of abdominal pain in pregnancy include obstetrical and gynecological, and gastrointestinal and genitourinary. Obstetrical history related to multigravida, previous obstetrical event are be recorded. Chronological as per performa is next slide. Performa in next slide scene to be relevant inquiry is to be made whether she had antenatal and intranatal care before. This is performa. And in numbers, year and date, pregnancy events, labor event, method of delivery, puerperium and baby weight, sex, condition at birth, duration of breastfeeding and immunization. For each pregnancy, age of mother when pregnant, antenatal complication, duration of pregnancy, detail of induction of labor, duration of labor, presentation, method of delivery, birth weight and sex of infant. Also inquire about any complication of the puerperal period. Possible complication, postpartum hemorrhage, infection of genitourinary tract, deep vein thrombosis, perineal complication, psychological complication. Obstetrical history can be summed up as status of gravida, parity, number of delivery, term or preterm, miscarriage, pregnancy, termination, MTP, and living issue. ये कुछ एग्जाम्पल दिया गया है, जो हिस्ट्री ली गई है उसकी ग्रेविडा, पेरिटी, नंबर ऑफ डिलीवरी, टर्म, प्रीटर्म और मिस कैरेज के अकॉर्डिंग. पास्ट गायनेकोलॉजिकल हिस्ट्री, मेथड ऑफ कॉन्ट्रासेप्शन, बिफोर कॉन्सेप्शन, सर्वाइकल स्मियर हिस्ट्री, कोइटल प्रॉब्लम, एनी सेक्सुअल ट्रांसमिटेड डिजीज और मेंस्ट्रुअल हिस्ट्री. मेंस्ट्रुअल हिस्ट्री, साइकिल, ड्यूरेशन, अमाउंट ऑफ ब्लड फ्लो, फर्स्ट डे ऑफ लास्ट नॉर्मल मेंस्ट्रुअल पीरियड. फ्रॉम लास्ट मेंस्ट्रुअल पीरियड द एक्सपेक्टेड डेट ऑफ डिलीवरी हैज टू बी कैलकुलेटेड. कैलकुलेशन ऑफ एक्सपेक्टेड डेट ऑफ डिलीवरी, दिस इज डन बाय नेगलेस फॉर्मूला. ठीक है, यूज ऑफ नेगलेस फॉर्मूला कैलकुलेटेड द ईडीडी, एक्सपेक्टेड डेट ऑफ डिलीवरी. नेगलेस फॉर्मूला इज कैलकुलेशन ऑफ एक्सपेक्टेड डेट ऑफ डिलीवरी डन बाय एडिंग 9 month and 7 day to the first day of last normal menstrual cycle. For IVF pregnancy, date of LMP is 14 days prior to the date of embryo transfer. ठीक है, 266 days. This is obstetrical calendar. Use for diagnosis of expected date of delivery. Past medical surgical history. Some medical condition may have impacted on the course of pregnancy, or pregnancy may have impacted on medical conditions such as heart disease, hypertension, diabetes, epilepsy, thyroid disease, asthma, and any previous surgery, kidney disease, UTI, autoimmune disease, psychiatric disease, hepatitis, venereal disease and blood transfusion, drug history and allergies, current medication taken at any time during the pregnancy, family history, any history of hereditary illness or congenital defect is important, is to require ensure adequate counseling and screening is offered. पर्सनल हिस्ट्री, कॉन्ट्रासेप्टिव हिस्ट्री. ठीक है, LMP में भी विथड्रॉल ब्लीड फॉलोइंग पिल यूजेस, स्मोकिंग या अल्कोहल हैबिट, या प्रीवियस हिस्ट्री ऑफ ब्लड ट्रांसफ्यूजन, कॉर्टिकोस्टेरॉइड थेरेपी, इम्यूनाइजेशन अगेंस्ट टिटनस, प्रोफाइलेक्सिस, एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन ऑफ एंटी डी इम्यूनोग्लोबिन आर टू बी रिक्वायर्ड. सोशल हिस्ट्री, ask about her partner, age, occupation, health, how stable relationship, any domestic violence. If she is not in relationship, who will give her support during after pregnancy. Ask if pregnancy has planned or not. If she work, inquire about her job and if she has any plan to return to work. Then examination part. Keyword before examination, explain to the patient the need and the nature of postponed examination. proposed examination, obtain a verbal consent. The examiner, either male or female, should be accompanied by another female. Respect her privacy and examine in a private room. Expose any relevant part for any anatomy of examination. Ensure the patient is comfortable and warm. Ask patient to empty the bladder. And patient should lie in the dorsal position with the thigh slightly flexed and stand tight to her. Then she is slightly rolled to the left side to prevent compression of inferior vena cava by the enlarged uterus. Ask for any tender area before palpating the abdomen. Then this position to be given: dorsal position, supine position with thigh slightly flexed. Position of the woman during obstetrical examination. Then general examination: vital data, nutritional status, height, facial features, yeah, expression, skin, uterus, legs, neck, breast. Then general examination: vital data, blood pressure record while she is sitting and semi recumbent, 45 degree angle posture record in every sitting. Using unaffected or slightly lower than normal due to systemic vascular resistant. If BP more than or equal 140/90 mmHg or 2 separated occasions 6 hours apart, then chronic hypertension is recorded before 20 week of pregnancy or may be persisted before pregnancy with positive family history. Gestation hypertension if recorded after 20 week of pregnancy. Pulse rate slightly increased, heart rate increased, murmur heard normal, continuous hissing murmur, systolic type also called mammary murmur, and respiratory rate usually unaffected, feels shortness of breath with slightly exertion due to elevation diaphragm. Then temperature may rise, temperature by 0.4 degree Fahrenheit, that is 98.6 degree Fahrenheit to 99 degree Fahrenheit due to increased metabolic rate cause of increased temperature. Nutritional status: nail, white spot in zinc deficiency, brittle nail in magnesium deficiency. Tongue may be large in iodine or niacin deficiency, may be pallor is ferrous deficiency. Cyanotic is congestive heart failure site dorsum of tongue. Weight: the abnormal nutrition status case described as obesity and emaciation, check weight in every visit. Parameter body mass index checking. Weight gain of woman with normal BMI is 11 to 16 kgs. Weight gain for a obese woman should be less than 7 kgs, and weight gain underweight woman is 18 kgs. Parameter help to early intervention of preeclampsia in obese and IUGR of fetus in underweight. Height: short stature women are mostly to suffer with small pelvis and they may cause IUGR of fetus. Facial feature or facial expression: some facial appearance are pathognomonic of disease. Here the patient may be having thyrotoxicosis. The appearance of patient face may also provide information regarding psychological makeup and person happy, sad, angry and anxious. And then skin: extreme pigmentation around neck, face, forehead common in pregnancy. Palmar erythema due to high estrogen. Hirsutism mild, common if more cussing. If hirsutism is more, then this disease called Hussing syndrome. Icterus means bulbar conjunctiva, under surface of tongue, hard palate to rule out any liver pathology. Leg edema common physiology, अदर कॉज प्रीएक्लेम्पसिया, एनीमिया, कार्डिक फेलियर, नेफ्रोटिक सिंड्रोम। पिगमेंटेशन ऑफ नेक एंड चीक्स, ओके, स्वालोइंग फीट ड्यूरिंग प्रेगनेंसी, दिस इज नॉर्मल फाइंडिंग। नेक, नेक वेन, थायरॉइड ग्लैंड डिफ्यूज एनलार्ज वुमेन इन प्रेगनेंसी 50% ऑफ केसेस। लिम्फ ग्लैंड एनलार्ज, एनी हिस्ट्री ऑफ कॉक्स, अदर पैथोजन लाइक लिम्फ नोड। ब्रेस्ट, एग्जामिनेशन ऑफ ब्रेस्ट इज मोंटगोमेरी, नॉट ओनली टू नोट प्रेजेंस ऑफ प्रेगनेंसी चेंजेस बट ऑल्सो नोट टू निपल और स्किन अराउंड एरियोला, एंड ब्रेस्ट चेंजेस आर एविडेंस बिटवीन 6 to 8 weeks। The nipples and areola become more pigmented, especially in dark women. Montgomery tubercle are prominent. Thick yellowish secretion, colostrum, can be expressed as early as 12 weeks. Breast can enlarge with vascular engorgement evidenced by delicated vein visible under the skin. Breast changes are valuable only in primigravida as in multigravida. The breasts are enlarged and often contain milk for years. Purpose is to correct the abnormality, cracked or fissure nipple early so that to make easy breastfeeding, more safety to infant after delivery. The neck is diffuse swelling, common 50% cases of pregnancy and abnormal swelling. Then breast, normal in pregnancy and abnormal in pregnancy. Then general systematic review. Then CNS, GIT, genitalia, urinary system and locomotory system. CNS is following finding are checked: sleepiness, mental irritability due to some psychological background, any depression, psychosis, anesthesia of thighs due to compression of lateral cutaneous nerve or carpal tunnel syndrome. And GIT is, gums is usually congested and spongy, esophageal reflex due to relaxed sphincter by progesterone. Constipation due to atony of intestine. Other sign of any disturbance should be noted clearly. Chances of gallstone due to rise cholesterol. Advise USG if pain in right hypochondria region. Abdominal examination can be examined in 3 parts: inspection, palpation, and auscultation. Then first is inspection. Size of uterus. If the length and breadth are both increased, multiple pregnancy, polyhydramnios condition. If the length is increased, only large baby. Shape, uterus. Shape of uterus is length should be larger than broad. This indicate longitudinal lie. But if the uterus is low and broad, indicated transfer fetal lie. And pendu plus abdomen in primigravida is sign of inlet contraction. Then inspection. If there is lateral implantation of placenta, then the uterus enlarged will be asymmetrical. This is a piskek sign. This is called piskek sign. Okay? If there is lateral implantation of placenta, then the uterus enlarged will asymmetrical piskek sign. Look for fetal movement. More prominent seen in third trimester, less in oligohydramnios. Look for scars and herniation. Cutaneous sign, linea nigra, stria gravida, stria albicans, and umbilicus flat or everted superficial veins seen in pregnancy, and skin condition ringworm scabies. Then you see the line between the umbilicus and superior part of the sternum to the symphysis pubis this linea nigra and striae gravida जो होते हैं वो जो लीनिया नाइग्रा के दोनों साइड में होते हैं स्ट्रिया ग्रेविडा, और दूसरी इमेज में जो है इवर्टेड अम्बिलिकस दिख रही है और फीटल पार्ट्स दिख रहे हैं। ठीक है, इस इमेज में देखिए ये है स्ट्रिया ग्रेविडा जो कि स्ट्रेचिंग के कारण डेवलप होते हैं, और ये है स्ट्रिया एल्बिकेंस जो थोड़े शाइनी मार्क्स होते हैं। उसके बाद में पाल्पेशन, एम पाल्पेशन के आइम्स क्या है, पाल्पेशन ऑफ फीटल पार्ट, एक्टिव फीटल मूवमेंट, हाइट ऑफ यूट्रस, सिम्फाइसिस, फंडल हाइट, जस्टेशन एज, फीटल पोल, फीटल लाई, प्रेजेंट इन पार्ट, सिफेलिक हेड या ब्रीथ प्रेजेंटेशन और एटीट्यूड, लेवल ऑफ एंगेजमेंट ऑफ प्रेजेंटिंग पार्ट, यूटेराइन कॉन्ट्रैक्शन, एस्टिमेट फीटल वेट, एमनियोटिक फ्लूड, एनी सिफेलिक पेल्विक डिस्प्रोपोर्शन ऑल ऑफ द अबो पैरामीटर, टू असेस फीटल पोल, फीटल लाई, फीटल प्रेजेंटिंग पार्ट, एटीट्यूड एंड एंगेजमेंट ऑफ फीटल हेड, लियोपोल्ड मैनूवर इज फॉलोड। पाल्पेशन ऑफ फीटल पार्ट डिस्टिंक्टली फेल्ट आफ्टर 20th वीक, यूजुअली डन टू एस्टिमेट द फीटल पोल या प्रेजेंटिंग पार्ट, एंड एक्टिव फीटल मूवमेंट इज गिवन पॉजिटिव एविडेंस ऑफ प्रेगनेंसी, felt at deliver by placing the hand over the uterus as early as 20 week indicated live fetus, intensity more in last trimester, then height of uterus, symphysis fundal height, the distance from the symphysis pubis to the uterine fundus top the uterus, size of uterus directly related to the size of fetus, techniques for height of uterus and symphysis fundal height measurement, place ulnar border of left hand on the highest part of the uterus or fundus. तो जो ulnar border है left hand का वो कि वो uterus के fundus पे place करना है। उसके बाद में mark this point with a pen after obtaining her permission. The distance between the upper border of the symphysis pubis up to marked point is measured by tape. This correspond for gestation age. Then techniques. So this is techniques of symphysis fundal height measurement. Then measurement of uterus is high. Fundal height is a measure in centimeter from the pubic symphysis to the topmost portion of uterus. Yeah, so 12 centimeter fundal height is जो 12 centimeter है वो symphysis, जो 12 centimeter पे जो uterus का जो fundus होता है वो symphysis pubis पे होता है, ठीक है, और जो 16 जो सेंटीमीटर पे जो fundal height होता है वो umbilicus और symphysis pubis के बीच में होता है, और 22 सेंटीमीटर पे या फिर हम इसको वीक्स के अकॉर्डिंग भी मेजरमेंट कर सकते हैं, जैसे कि 12 वीक पे जो फंडल होता है यूट्रस का जो फंडस होता है वो सिम्फाइसिस प्यूबिस पे होता है, और 22 वीक्स पे अम्बिलिकस पे होता है, और 16 वीक पे अम्बिलिकस और सिम्फाइसिस प्यूबिस के बीच में जो यूट्रस का फंडस होता है, ठीक है, और जो 28 वीक पे यूट्रस का फंडस जो है वो अम्बिलिकस से ऊपर होता है, और 38 वीक पे जो यूट्रस का फंडस है वो जिफी स्टर्नम तक हो जाता है, ठीक है, और देन उसके बाद में 40 वीक पे वापस से जो यूट्रस है वो नीचे की तरफ आता है, ठीक है, तो वो जो जिफी स्टर्नम से थोड़ा नीचे आ जाता है 40 वीक पे, ठीक है, और जो 32 वीक्स पे है वो यूट्रस का फंडस जो होता है वो अम्बिलिकस और जिफी स्टर्नम के बीच में होता है। उसके बाद में जेस्टेशन एज, द डिस्टेंस फ्रॉम द सिम्फाइसिस प्यूबिस टू द यूटेराइन fundus top of the uterus corresponding the gestation and duration of pregnancy. जैसा हमें मैंने बताया after the 24 week of pregnancy the distance measured in centimeter normally correspond to the period of gestation in weeks. ठीक है. Then symphysis, इसमें देखते हैं symphysis fundal height. Then gestation age chart estimated from symphysis fundal height. देन ये 60, 20, 24 week, 28 week ये वीक में है और इधर सिम्पाइसिस फंडल हाइट इन सेंटीमीटर्स में है. ठीक है, तो उसके अकॉर्डिंग हम ये चार्ट बनाते हैं कि कितने वीक पे जो फंडल हाइट है वो कितने सेंटीमीटर पे है. देन उसके बाद फिफ्थ है फीटल पोल लाई प्रेजेंटिंग पार्ट एंगेजमेंट एंड एटीट्यूड ऑफ फीटस हेड आर असेस्ड बाय लियोपोल्ड मैन्यूवर. तो लियोपोल्ड मैन्यूवर है वो हम नेक्स्ट क्लास में पढ़ेंगे. ओके, थैंक यू.